In this video, I'm going to be showing you guys perfect rotations where you are able to pass, shoot, and defend pretty much all at once. Make sure you guys stay tuned where I share all my tips and tricks for rotating, as well as do a giveaway in the middle of the video for $50. So make sure you guys watch out for that. Let's get into it. What is going on, YouTube? Welcome back to another video. Today, I'm going to be showing you the secret to ranking up and ranking up fast, and that is rotations. A lot of players do not know how to rotate properly, so in this video I am doing live commentary while I play, showing you how I rotate, how you should be rotating, what you shouldn't be doing, kind of each role for rotating. If you guys want a more in-depth video of me like going into replay mode and showing you scenarios, just smash the like button, leave a comment down below, and I will definitely do that. But let's get into the video, guys.
Hope you guys are having a good one. All right, I am full front, so I'm going to go for boost here because I trust that my teammates are going to be back, which they are. I am next, though. I get bumped. Man, he's on the ball. Porkins is going to drive past me and go for the ball, so I'm going to play net here. Man, he's up, so I'm still going to play net, and now I'm going to come out. I am second, so I don't really have to worry about back rotating. As you can see, I'm here for the shot. It's unlucky. I'm going to get this boost and rotate back and let my teammates go. Manny is all the way back, so I'm going to stay mid here. Try to play off a pass. He's not there, so I'm going to go for a shot. Unlucky. Barely miss. Teammate wasn't there. I'm just going to rotate. Manny's on the ball. Porkins is, should be next if he plays his rotation. And it looks like I am next. Porkins gets demoed, so I am next on the ball now. I'm going to continue off this, try to get this mid for a teammate, and then I'm going to rotate back. Porkins is in the goal, I'm in the goal now. I'm just going to play the ball now. Manny's going to go for the ball, so I'm going to stay in goal. Basically, whenever a teammate is going for the ball, you just want to let them go for the ball and stay behind them most of the time, unless you're on an attack. As you see, I'm last man. So right there, my teammate was driving towards me, which means he is going to go behind me, which signals that I am next on the ball because he's not going to hit the ball is what that's signaling to me. Porkins is going to go, so I'm going to be last man. So I'm going to just get boost and kind of chill for a bit. Porkins is next. He should shoot here. He doesn't. Manny's next. And I get demoed, so I'm last guy. So I'm going to play boost here. Porkins gets demoed. Manny with a good save. I'm next on the ball, and that's a wide open net. So that was really good right there. We had a triple commit from them. As you can see, Secretary should not have gone for the ball there. Or actually, he should have gone for the ball there. But CME, G-Max, he should have been back right there. He should have rotated sooner. So that gave us the open net to go up 4-0. I missed the ball here. Manny's going to be on the ball, so I'm just going to go for boost. Porkins is all the way back. So basically, at all times, I am scanning the field to check where the ball is, where I am, and where my teammates are. Those are the three things I'm keeping in mind at all time. So as you can see, Manny is in front of me, so I'm going to stay behind him at all times because he is next on the ball. I'm just waiting patiently because I know this is not going to end well. Manny is signaling to me that he's going to hit this ball, so I'm going to wait. Porkins should be behind me, so I should be safe to go for the ball now. I do miss the ball. Manny is up, which was kind of a bad rotation by him, but it's fine. I'm going to go ahead and go for this because I'm closest to the ball. I'm going to let go of this because Manny's right here. It should be me going for a shot here. Unlucky. Good save. Porkins is on the ball. Manny's to my right. I'm going to go ahead and go to goal here. Manny is closer to you, so he should hit the ball here, which he does. Porkins should be behind me, which he is. So this is signaling me that it is my turn to hit the ball now. I'm going to try to hit this middle. I'm going to continue off of this because I know my teammates are not in a position to hit that. Manny's going to miss. Porkins is going at the ball. And so right there, Manny misses. Porkins goes for the ball. So that signals to me that I need to go back immediately because we have no one covering the net. We have both of my teammates are on the ball. Porkins is in a beautiful position for that. I'm on the right side, Porkins is on the left, and our teammate Manny is back. That was absolutely perfect positioning right there. I'm telling you guys, it's really this simple. You know, you get rotations down, and I promise you, you are going to start winning more games. Because you essentially have you know, everybody has a job. So as you can see, Porkins missed, Manny's so far. And so normally what people would do is they would aggress and push up on that ball, leaving the goal wide open. But right there, you just need to make sure you play patiently because you're the last man. Porkins is in the goal now, so I'm going to kind of come out a little bit. And Porkins is staying in the goal, so he's playing his rotation beautifully, and that's just a good shot. So as you can see, absolutely perfect rotation right there. Manny is on the ball. I need to play off of the pass from Manny since he's on the ball. So whenever your teammate has the ball, you need to either A, be in the goal as last man, or B, playing the pass. I saw that Porkins was staying in goal, which means I need to be playing off the pass on Manny, and that's a beautiful goal right there. If Porkins were to go up right there to play the pass, then I would just simply stay in goal. Porkins is going back. Manny's coming up. I'm going to go for this and hope that Manny's playing his rotation, which he is. Manny should be coming up now, and Porkins should be going back. Porkins didn't really play his position there well, but it doesn't matter because it's a 5-0 win. And that's game one for you guys. All right, so I'm on the kickoff here. That kickoff's going to them. So off kickoff, if it goes to them, I'm going to immediately go back. I am last guy here, and that's just kind of out of my reach. I didn't really have booster there, and that wasn't really anyone's fault. I think that was just a good play from there. Let's go ahead and re-rack. All right, so this is actually good. So what I'm going to do here, okay, so if he missed that, then obviously that's me. I am last man, so I'm going to take my time. I actually do want to take a moment and point out here, I didn't actually like specifically say it in the video when I was commentary, but as you can see, Ethereal does get demoed here. When your teammates get demoed, that automatically puts them behind you. So Ethereal will be last man because he got demoed, and since Mago is in front of me, that puts me as second man. I didn't actually say that in video, but I just wanted to let you guys know. Ethereal is now last man, so I can come up now. My teammate is in the middle. That's perfect right there. Ethereal really, in a realistic situation, he should not have came up there just because Mago was already there. He should have stayed back in goal just in case. As you can see, Ethereal does not know how to play rotations. Mago does, though. But Ethereal does not know how to play rotations. And this is actually good. I kind of like that we have a teammate who doesn't know how to play rotations, so I can show you kind of what not to do. As you can see, Ethereal is he's just kind of too close right there. I'm demoed, so now both my teammates should play up right now. Mago is playing off of Ethereal's hit, which I like. As you can see, he's going to go up. Ethereal should go back, and I should be playing the pass. Now, I was very conservative right there. I should have been more aggressive. The reason I was conservative is because I know Ethereal does not know how to play rotations well, so I was kind of playing on the more conservative side. But right there, if I knew that Ethereal was going to play his rotation and rotate back, then I would have definitely been more aggressive on that hit. I'm going to hit it to the right. Not really the best hit for me, but also not really the best position from Ethereal, but I'll take the blame on that because that wasn't really a good hit for me. I just kind of forced a hit right there, and it would have been better to just let that hit go by me, let the ball go by me. As you can see, it's really hard to play rotations when you also have a teammate not playing rotations. Ethereal should not be coming up on me with kickoff, but you know, it's really fine. We're having a good time. This should be me. Now that I'm back, Mago should be going up. Absolute perfect rotation from Mago. And the reason you may be wondering, well, if you're last man, why'd you go up for that hit? Is because I am last man in the moment, but by the time someone hits the ball, because there's no one around, by the time someone hits the ball, rather that's me or the other opponent, one of the teammates should be back. So because they committed to the ball, they should be immediately rotating back. So I know that I can come up because no one's near the ball. And by the time that I get to that ball, my teammate should be back, which I'm pretty sure did happen. This is the gayest song I think I've ever heard in my life. No idea why this shit is playing. I'm literally skipping right now. Alright, So I'm going to play back here. Mago should be playing off the pass, which he is. As you can see, Mago's turn, which he misses. I played a little up right there. I definitely should have stayed back a little bit. We'll take the L on that one. I'm not really too sure why we were losing that game. I don't know if it's because we weren't playing rotations well. But, you know, at the end of the day, I'm hoping that I did my part well. But let me know in the comments if you think I'm playing rotations correctly or not. That was a banger shot, Jesus. And that is going to conclude this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope it helped you out. Leave a comment down below. Smash the like button if that did help you out. And if you did catch that giveaway alert in the video, make sure you comment down below what you think he did wrong, and I'll be giving $50 to the first person that comments the correct answer. If you guys would like more videos like this, I can cover other topics like how to shoot, how to save, how to air dribble, how to flip reset, all that things. Make sure you smash the like button, and I will definitely do more of these. And subscribe if you're new. I hope you guys have a great rest of your night, and I'll see y'all next time. Surprise when you call.